Besides that, Becky Lynch won the NXT Women's title from Tiffany Stratton last night, clean with a manhandle, which was kind of surprising. Wasn't expecting Becky to walk out of there. But, you know, over the last few weeks, I got this feeling like the Becky Lynch-Tiffany Stratton feud that's being built is very reminiscent of Ripley and Charlotte, don't you think?
Yeah, I think so. I thought it was a good match. I don't hate that they gave Becky, because they talked about it. Nick Khan talked about this a few months ago. People just don't pay attention, or they have select memory. That NXT was going to be put in a position to be the legit third brand. Yes, it's still in wrestlers in training, so to speak. But there's also going to be there's established people ready for the roster. And it's going to be considered like a third brand show. Listen, they got major USA Network time at prime time on television on Tuesday night. And if they put more stars in there, they'll raise the ratings. I'm sure Becky being on last night, I didn't see the rating yet for today. I don't know if it's out yet. Is it Mesh for NXT no. last night? But I'm sure it's up. Right. Becky's not the big deal that she was in 2018-19, but she still has cachet. She's got name. I wouldn't be surprised if they were up 100,000, which is good for that kind of situation. You know, they got guys like Bron Breakker, who's more than ready down there. But I think there's some people, Carmelo Hayes, there's people who need to cook a little bit more. But I think that they're putting people down there. And Becky wasn't doing much. I mean, the Trish Stratus thing is over. Trish is gone. Becky has to move on now. Obviously, Zoe Stark is now with Shayna Baszler. So Becky needs something to do. And I don't hate that she's down there. And, they killed Tiffany Stratton. No, they didn't. They didn't get the dramatics with these wrestling fans who don't know wrestling, let alone common sense. They didn't kill anybody. If anything, Tiffany Stratton's name is in a lot more people's ears now after that match last night. Thought the match was good, and I thought it was okay the way she pinned her. I didn't think it'd make Tiffany look weak at all. And Tiffany's 2 years in the business. What's to make her look weak? She's still learning. You know what I mean? It's like, what's the bit? She lost to Becky Lynch. She didn't lose to Sweet Hansen. You know what I mean? So I don't get that. Like, you know, it hurt Tiffany. No, it didn't. Learn wrestling.
I mean, it's literally the same exact storyline with Charlotte.
It's the same storyline. But again, you're for someone like Tiffany to be in the ring with Becky and have a match like that. And listen, it's going to lead to other matches. I don't think this is one and done. You think this is one and done?
Not at all. I think that's what I'm saying. Is like, this is going to eventually lead up to maybe even eventually a WrestleMania match. Look, Ripley wasn't lighting the NXT UK on fire. She was great when she was there, but by the time she came to WWE and NXT in the US, you know, it was a different story. When Charlotte beat her in NXT, don't you remember people losing their fucking minds when Ripley beat when Charlotte beat Ripley? Oh my God, they're burying Ripley. Ripley's done. You know, Charlotte is just such a bully. She has to go down to NXT and beat women that have a potential chance of being stars there. And they did it again. And it really fucking made people fly off the handle. And then they brought it all together at WrestleMania for the main event of WrestleMania, Kev. And it was probably the best match of the night. So why wouldn't WWE look at the success of Ripley versus Charlotte and what a major star Ripley is right now and think, oh, maybe we could do it with Becky and somebody else. Oh, I know, Tiffany Stratton. There's a lot of good overhead on Tiffany Stratton. Let's try this same formula, see if lightning can strike twice.
Absolutely, and thank you, Andy. Andy posted something here with the NXT rating for Stratton versus Becky Lynch. Averaged 850,000 viewers, which is up from last week's 673,000. So she tacked on almost 200K. That's pretty good, would you say, Mish? That's that's on par with Wednesday Night Dynamite.
It's beating out Collision. So
it's beating the brand. You can put Collision and a couple other of their bullshit shows on there. That's not bad. Again, that's for what's going on now and for the expectations of NXT. That's pretty good. And listen, I don't get the logic of people saying, oh, they depend on bringing AJ Styles and Becky Lynch and who's going to be their next Roman Reigns. They own the fucking company. They all work. They get the same paycheck. Why not utilize your people? That's like saying, oh, why did the Mets bring up Mercurio from Triple? They need him. Yes, need him. That's why they brought him up. He's part of the Mets system. It's so stupid. Why not utilize people you have on the payroll? Of course. Why can't? And if Roman Reigns does make an appearance in NXT, great. That's fucking great. That's part of the company. That's part of the same fucking team. NXT isn't not non-WWE related. So I always laugh when they're like, sure, they need Becky Lynch to get the rub. Yeah. What's the insult? I don't get it. You understand what I'm saying?
Right. Oh, no, totally.
You can utilize something.
Dude, I was happy as shit when they fucking brought Corbin down there. I was like, Corbin isn't doing anything on WWE. Put him down in NXT. They brought Ricochet down there. Same feel. Ricochet had a great match. I think it was with Hayes, right? Like, bring him down there. I don't have a problem with the vets that aren't really working a program right now to go down to NXT.
Absolutely.
If people are against that, that's a little silly. I think that's the fandom speaking more than business sense, you know?
But they're part of the same team. They are acting like WWE went out and contracted someone who doesn't work for the company to give the club, the show a rub. These guys work there. So if they get the call, hey, tomorrow night, Ricochet, you and, you know, matter of fact, tomorrow night, Samantha Irving, we want you to announce at NXT. You got to fill in for the girl. She's like, oh, but I don't work at NXT. I can't. But they work for the same company. I scratch my head. I'm like, listen, I understand that some people depend on their fan base to be stupid. Thank God we don't. We don't have that kind of fan base in Wrestling Soup. But I just amazing to me of people who like agree with that kind of logic. Oh, they're depending on that.
But they
can use it because it's at their fingertips. You utilize what you have at your fingertips.
Think about it like this. This is the same thing that independent promotions do all the time. Independent promotions will bring in legends or other wrestlers that aren't signed to TV deals in order to get more people to tune in order to get more people to buy a ticket and show up at the show. You know, it's not like people are really looking for X-Pac to highlight the show, but if he comes out there and surprises everyone, people are into it. I don't understand the method of like, oh, well, X-Pac just, you know, he has to bury some no-name out of Idaho to make himself feel better or something.
Again, like I said, it's like when the Mets brought up these great prospects, like, oh, some respect they're giving to their normal right fielder. He's got to sit now because this new kid is taking his spot. That's baseball. This is wrestling. People claim to be expert, and they're so knowledgeable and enthusiast and historian, and you don't know even the basics of business sense. It's not taking anybody's spot. They're on the same fucking team, and they need to be peppered in. At some point, you got to give somebody playing time in the game, don't you, Mish?
Right.
Jesus.
I'm just saying. And I agree with Joe. Joe's like, you know, $700 for a name, $75 for a local name, indie wrestling for 20 years. Totally agree. The whole reason you bring in somebody that's worth more money is because it's special. It gets people to turn in. It gets people to want to watch or buy a ticket.
Follow Wrestling Soup on Twitter at Wrestling Soup. Like and subscribe to Wrestling Soup on YouTube. And check out the Discord for live chat during the shows at discord.gg/wrestlingsoup. Check out and subscribe to the shows on Apple, Amazon, iHeartRadio, Spotify,
and more.